Hello guys, it's Kimmerafair and welcome to another video. So I'm not doing this as I usually do. I'm gonna do a live com talking about a certain topic whilst I'm playing a match, whilst handling that topic, I guess. So yeah, anyway, we'll just get straight into a match and let's talk about this shit. Okay, so we are in a match. Already started, no big deal. So anyway, what I wanted to talk about is this gun, the STG. Okay, so the STG-44, there's a big discussion going on. Is the gun overpowered or is it overused? In the first patch, it did get a nerf, I think. Don't exactly remember what it is, what the nerf is. It wasn't very major. I mean, nothing, not a single nerf or buff was really major. So, anyway. Ooh, that was nice. Anyway, so let's talk about this. Is the gun overpowered or overused? My opinion, just overused. It's a good gun. It's like the traditional Call of Duty starter gun. Not high damage, not low damage, not a lot of recoil, and easy to use. That's why it's used a lot. That's why, in my opinion, it's overused. Is it overpowered? I don't think so. People always get the impression of something being overpowered if it's overused. Because, well, it's basic logic. If something is used a lot, it's overpowered, surely. It isn't. Not in this case. Okay. Whatever. Anyway. So, yeah. It is overused. And are there ways to counter this? I mean, you can nerf it and make it a bad gun, but you can't nerf it too much to make it too bad of a gun, if you know what I mean. So Sledgehammer is kind of in a difficult situation here. They can't do too much to the gun, but if they don't do anything, they'll get a lot of flak for it. Now, if you look at the stats of my gun, headshots doesn't really matter, really. But if you just look at the stats, I mean, you can't really see them here. I got 800 kills with it. And when I use infantry, it has been primarily the STG. I've got 222 KD. Now, STG is going to be about the same. That's slightly above my average, I think. 216 KD at the moment. So it's slightly above my average. But that's just because it's the type of gun I enjoy using. The niche of it. It's a good mid-range gun, short range, not terribly, long range, not terribly. I'm probably going to be able to show this off in this match on the USS Texas. This is a, I don't know, it's close range and long range map. Mid-range, not too much. So the STG does have a niche on this map, mostly just protection. For Indomination, but this is TDM, so it's a whole other dynamic. Movement at the stern. There we go. Look, oh, okay. That was the range you need to use it at. I don't know why the fuck that guy is using Mountain Division with a shotgun. I mean, use whatever division you want. If you're using Mountain Division, use a fucking sniper. That's just my opinion. Really annoys me if people don't do it. Whatever. That's just me, I guess. Wow. That grenade was a fail and a half. Oh my god, double headshot. Nice, I guess. Don't know where the fuck that came from. There you go. That's why you do actually need to use the correct division for this gun. Because bayonet charge is just so good on this gun. It really... it negates its weakness, and that's short range. There we go. See, this is what I meant with the niche of the STG. You need to use it defensively. Hold down a position, keep your enemies at range. At a range where you know you can outgun them. Don't challenge me, bitch. Thank you, teammates. There we go. Now we got a recon aircraft. We can already do a lot more. Because we know where they are. Unless they're using mountain. Oh my god. Okay, too bad we lost. Anyway, so I hope I made it clear why this gun is not overpowered, but just overused. And I hope my gameplay at least slightly showed it. So anyway, hope you enjoyed. My name is Ben Kinrafit as always. I'm signing off. See ya.